हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम कृष्णा, स्टूडेंट ऑफ राजीव गांधी गवर्नमेंट इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज नगरोटा बगवा, ईसी फोर्थ सेम। माय प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन फॉस्टर सिले एफएम डिस्क्रिमिनेटर बेसिस। इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द वर्किंग ऑफ फेस डिस्क्रिमिनेटर और फॉस्टर सिले डिस्क्रिमिनेटर। वी नो दैट द फंक्शन ऑफ एफएम डिमोडुलेटर इज टू चेंज द एफएम और फ्रिक्वेंसी मॉड्युलेटिंग वेव इनटू द ऑर्डिनरी मॉड्युलेटिंग सिग्नल। That is, we have to convert the frequency variation into amplitude variation. The basic method of for FM demodulation are slope detector and balanced slope detector. The basic concept of slope detector or Foster-Seeley discriminator is same as balanced slope detector and slope detector method. And this is the at the output of circuit we intend to get S-shaped frequency response. To get S-shaped frequency response, the meaning of the S-shaped frequency response is that the output voltage of the circuit is directly proportional to the incoming signal. So, we can say in the slope detector or balanced slope detector or phase discriminator, the output frequency response is S-shaped. This is the basic concept. So, in order to fully understand the functioning of phase discriminator, it is better to understand the basic functioning of slope detector and balanced slope detector. Though the basic functioning of the phase discriminator is the same as slope detector, but in this case the shortcoming which are associated with two earlier method has been removed. So the shortcoming of the slope detector and balanced slope detector is that they in through circuit that are tuned circuit, and in each of the circuit of tuned circuit has to maintain at different frequencies. For example, in slope detector method, the primary and secondary tuned circuit of the transformer have to maintain at two different resonant frequencies, and the balanced slope detector method, the primary and secondary tuned circuit has to maintain at three different resonant frequencies. So in any circuit, it is very difficult to maintain the primary and secondary of the transformer at different frequencies. But in phase discriminator, this complexity has been removed. And in this method, the transformer, the primary and secondary are tuned at same resonant frequency. This is the most simplest method to getting a modulating signal in all FM modulating ways. So now we discuss about the working of phase discriminator. This is a circuit of phase discriminator. In this circuit, L1 C1 is tuned circuit of primary coil and L2 C2 is tuned circuit of secondary coil. As I have mentioned earlier, both these circuits are maintained or tuned at same resonant frequencies, that is the carrier frequency or central frequency. Let us say the frequency as FC. Now there are certain conditions which are imposed on the value of circuit component. For example, the resistance of the load resistance R3 and R4. The value of resistance R3 and R4 are very high in comparison with the capacitor reactance or of C4 and C. That is, if we compare the resistance C4 and capacitor reactance of C4, then C4 is very much higher than the capacitive reactance C4. If we consider the current arm C, L3 and C4, then we can say that since R4 is very high, the current which is passing through the upper circuit arm will not going through R4 because its value is very high. Therefore, we can say that R4 can be taken as open circuit. So now, and the circuit arm C, L3 and C4 are directly connected to the ground. Or we can say in other words that this circuit C, L3 and C4 comes directly in parallel with the primary circuit. In this next slides, as it is showing figure A of the slide, if C, L3 and C4 comes directly in parallel with the primary circuit, therefore the voltage V12 is directly applied to the circuit arm C, L3 and C4. And we know that the capacitive reactance of C and C4, these values are very small. Therefore, the entire voltage V12 will appear across the inductor coil L3. Hence, the voltage across the inductor coils L3 is V12, that it is primary voltage. The primary voltage V12 appear across the primary coil. And due to this primary coil voltage, the current IS is flowing in secondary coil. So, some secondary voltage produces. Firstly, let us see what happened at resonance. So, at resonance condition, the inductive reactance of the circuit becomes equal to the capacitive reactance. And the circuit which contains resistance, inductance, capacitance become purely resistive. So, we will consider the position and condition of resonance. Therefore, the secondary circuit and primary circuit, they become purely resistive. Therefore, the current IS is flowing through the circuit. And voltage V12 produce the secondary current. And we know through a resistive circuit, the voltage and current are in the same phase. Hence, the secondary current IS and the primary voltage V12 produces the secondary current. They are in the same phase. Hence, the voltage V12 which is produced across L3 and current in the secondary circuit, that is IS, are in same phase. Now, let us focus on the current through secondary coil. As the current IS flowing through the secondary coil, then this is pure inductive inductor coil. This current IS flowing through the secondary coil, it will reduce the secondary voltage. And this secondary voltage is VAB. Now, let us concentrate on the upper circuit that is contained diode D1. Two voltages are applied to the diode. The first is half of the secondary voltage, that is VAB. And the voltage across L3 is V12. The phase difference between V12 and half VAB is 90 degrees. And the resonant of these two letters, this is VAO. This next voltage applied across the diode D1, that is VAO. Similarly, if we are containing the lower circuit, the diode D2, then the diode D2 is getting voltage V12 and half VAB. And the resonant of the two voltages is we have shown VBO. VAO and VBO both have same magnitude and they are in opposite direction. And we can say that the voltage VBO and VAO are of the same magnitude. Hence, they produce same current through the diode D1 and through the diode D2. Both current are same. So, but the direction of the current in D1 is clockwise direction. And the direction of diode through the D2 is anti-clockwise. Hence, the voltage produced at the resistor R3 and R4, they are of the same magnitude, but they are in opposite direction. Hence, we will take the total voltage across the output. Then, these two voltages cancel out each other and output voltage at the resonant frequency will be zero. Now, we will see in resonant frequency in this diagram. Now, let us see what happens when the frequency of incoming signal is greater than resonant frequency, that is Fi and Fc. So, in this diagram, the frequency of incoming signal is greater than the resonant frequency, that is Fi greater than Fc. We know that in any circuit which contains inductor, resistance, capacitance, when the frequency of the signal is greater than the resonant frequency, when the inductive reactance is greater than the capacitive reactance, in this case, when the incoming signal is greater than resonant frequency, the primary and secondary circuit start behind some word like inductive circuit. So, in an inductive circuit, the current lag behind the voltage, which is produces in Therefore, we can say that the secondary current IS, which is produced by the primary voltage V12, that will lag behind IS, or secondary current will lag behind the primary voltage V12. In this case, the resonance IS and V12 are in the same direction. So, we can say that there is no phase difference between IS and V12. But in this case of inductive circuit, there is secondary circuit IS lag behind the primary voltage V12 by some lag. The secondary voltage is produced by the secondary current IS passing through the inductive coil. Therefore, the voltage VAB across the secondary coil leads the secondary current IS by 90 degrees. At this phase, the angle between voltage VAB and IS is 90 degrees. We can see from the figure C that the net result is that vector VAB is slightly tuned in the clockwise direction. In this direction, due to this development, hence the angle between half VAB and V12 is increased, so upper angle is decreased. Lower angle is increased in figure C. The resonant voltage VAO is increased and resultant voltage VOB is decreased. VOB is applied across the diode D2 and VO is a voltage applied through diode D1. Hence, the frequency of the incoming signal is greater than the resonant frequency. Then the resultant become positive. And the figure D. When the incoming signal in figure D is smaller than the resonant frequency, the current behaving like capacitive circuit. And when the circuit is capacitive, then the current leads to voltage, the secondary current leads the primary voltage. Hence the vector half VAB shift the anti-clockwise and angle between half VAB and V12 will be decreases. Hence the voltage across R3 is similar to the voltage across R4 is greater than the net output voltage, which is equal to the upper voltage minus lower voltage, will be negative. So, frequency response. In frequency response, our frequency is less than resonant frequency, then output voltage is negative and the input frequency is decreases in increase on negative sign. So, we can say that the output frequency response of the phase discriminator or Foster seal discriminator is S-shaped. The S-shape will be required when the circuit will be designed. Now, let us focus on the advantage and disadvantage of the phase discriminator. So, first advantage is offer good level of performance and reasonable linearity. Simple to construct using this discrete component. Provide higher output than the ratio detector. Provide a more linear output that is lower distortion than the ratio detector. Now see some drawbacks that is does not easily lead itself to behind incorporated within the integrated circuit. High cost of transformer, narrow band than the ratio detector. The circuit is sensitive to both frequencies and amplitude and therefore need a limiter before it removes the amplitude variation and hence amplitude noise. So this is the full description about the Foster-Seeley discriminator, and thank you for watching.